In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, Presbyterian College goes to Louisiana to face some tough competition. Three games in all. We'll talk about those games with the coach, Gregg Nibert, and a lot more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball. We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with the coach, Gregg Nibert. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Glad that you could spend your afternoon with us. And, coach, you take your show on the road. You face three excellent opponents down in Louisiana as part of the Coaches versus Cancer Clinic tournament down there. You opened up with American, and you played probably the best defense that I've seen in a long time. Really shut them down in the first half. Then you took on a very good Morehead State team, and then you capped it off with a host school with La Tech.
Well, we did, Eric, and I couldn't have been prouder of our basketball team. I really challenged
Absolutely.
Them defensively
yes.
After the Piedmont game, and we really came out there against a team, American, that won 20-some games, had four starters back, went to the NCAA
That's right.
tournament,
mm-hmm.
and they play a Princeton style of offense, and our guys just showed a tremendous amount of discipline and patience,
right.
and I think we're down maybe 4 points at halftime. It was a mm-hmm. close game and really played great defense. The bugaboo that got us all weekend was turnovers, and had 27 turnovers that game. Then played a very good, as you mentioned, Morehead State team who really pressed us from the get-go, a very athletic team. And again, another team that we were right in the game, but had 20 turnovers. We changed the lineup a little bit and got our substitutions. Brought in Devon Bell and played him mm-hmm. at the point and with Janiel, and moved Austin and Marcus over there, and felt like we had good chemistry there. And then did the same thing against Louisiana Tech, and with 8 minutes to go in that game in the first half, it's 20-19.
That's right.
But have five straight possessions of turnovers and end up losing that game 76-48, and played zone the last couple days. But, again, they had 28 points off our turnovers, and that was exactly the number that we lost by, and turnovers are really affecting us. But I couldn't have been prouder of what we did that whole entire weekend
mm-hmm.
of getting better. Finding chemistry. Again, we can't turn the ball over, but played really good defense at both man-to-man and zone.
Going back to that American contest, you were talking about the Princeton style, because their head coach used to play at Princeton, was assistant there for quite some time. Only three of those back cuts, only three of those Princeton layups there on the back door on that baseline we gave up. That was a tremendous effort. And you mentioned the fact about turning the ball over. I want to ask you, defense first, correct?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, you know, you know, with this new young team, with a very new young team, that down the road, the offense is going to catch up with the defense. Is that where you like it?
Well, exactly. We got to set the base for it, and
right.
the guys got to know how hard they got to play defensively, and that's what we did man-to-man-wise and got better at it. And then we really, without a whole lot of work, played zone the next
That's
two
right.
games, and really for a young basketball team to play that kind of zone, and even to play against that Princeton style, I couldn't have been, you know, prouder of a team to not have as much work and to do as well as they did.
Presbyterian College finished up that three-game set with La Tech. We have highlights of that contest. Presbyterian really gave it their all in that game.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Well, this was a great game for us against a very athletic Louisiana Tech game. Marcus Terrier hits a three. His defender falls down and knocked a shot down, and was really, they really got after us defensively. Again, turning the basketball over. But again, they get on the wrong side, and Marcus goes in there, and he's got our first 5 points of the game. Again, they pressed us. Good pass there by Ed. Again, we like to break the press and go right into our – again, they leave Jordan Downing open, and he makes him pay for that, pressing us. Again, Jordan hitting another shot. We're staying right there with him, which you want to do in the first 4 minutes. Again, another good – they're pressing us. We had our outlets. At times, we did a great job. Again, Marcus, the shot clock was going down. Again, Ed getting the offensive rebound and laying it in. Ed's doing a tremendous job on the boards. Again, fighting right there. Man done block him out, and a great finish by Ed. Again, we're right in the game, as you can see, with 10 minutes to go. We're down five. Again, we're playing him zone, keeping him in front of us. Again, moving on every pass, and you see we got a guy on every pass. Need to get a little more pressure on the ball. We got to really work on pressure there. We get two guys on the ball. They're a great contest by Jordan. And then we're pushing the basketball, taking it down there to secondary. Want to swing the ball. We need to swing that ball faster. Again, they get on the wrong side of Ruben. And great job by Ruben in there. A freshman who's just going to be unbelievable. Again, right in there, the first 9 minutes there. 10 minutes of the game, 18 to 15. The pace is exactly what we wanted. We want to keep the game hopefully in the 50s or 60s. We had it exactly where we wanted it here. Again, curl right there. A set play to get Will the ball. That's on 6-10, and Will was just tremendous. I believe he went 6-for-7. And we really found us something. Our whole team did. And
sure did.
Knowing how good Will Truss is down there inside. Again, 18 to 17 with 9 minutes to go. Again, we're not putting enough pressure on the ball. There we got a little turnover. 20 to 17 with 8:34 to go. Again, we're playing a team that has a very good chance of going to the NCAA tournament. Great pass in there. Again, 20 to 19 with 8-something to go. We're obviously right in the game. And then that's when we had 5 turnovers in a row. Again, nice pass there. And great finish by Ruben, but you can see the score was blown up because of our 5 turnovers right in the row. We didn't give it our defense a set. There again, getting the ball down there to Will. Great post feed. And it's really like taking candy from a baby down there on how easy that was for Will. And we found that. Here's Will running the floor. Again, great job by Marcus. We need to do a little bit more of that driving the basketball. Again, going down there to Will Truss. A right hand, he goes to the middle, comes back with a counter. Really good job. There's Daniil in there, coming in there for Devon. We started those two guys at guard. Again, driving the ball, and we get a lay-in. Great drive there. Again, it's a 17-point game. We got a chance to cut it to 15 right here. Great finish there by Daniil. Again, we're down there 15 points but again, turnovers again really hurt us. Great inbounds play there by Devon hitting Will Truss. But again, they got 28 points off our turnovers. And a little set play to get Will the ball. Again, watch him go to work down here. Take the guy in the middle, reverse back, making a layup on a guy that's 6'10". Again, now we're getting the ball down there to him. They're double teaming. And then now Devon drives it in there. What a great finish that was by Devon Bell and him being there at the point. He's just going to get better and better as time goes on. Again, look at Ruben right there. Great pass. You're going up and under on the other side of the rim with a freshman.
Again, Coach, your defense played lights out against all three opponents for at least a half. And the whole ball game was determined by our offense. Yeah, you said it. Too many turnovers. But, gosh, our guys played good physical defense.
Well, they did, Eric, and that's where the shooting percentages were even exactly
right.
What you kind of want. But when the guys are intercepting the ball and running it for touchdowns, your defense even looks a little bit worse. But we never got a chance to get our defense set, so it's just real encouraging that one of the keys to our defense is our offense, and not turning the ball over. But we proved we could play man-to-man end zone.
That's right.
And even though you did it for a half, but our turnovers in both halves really killed us. And it's something we're going to learn from and get better at.
Let's go ahead, Coach, take our first time out. When we come back, the Blue Hose return to Clinton to take on the Eagles of Toccoa Falls. We'll talk about that matchup, look at those highlights and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton.
Oh, you won't believe what just happened.
Don't tell me you got the last Diet Dew.
Yeah.
I love the taste of Diet Dew. What do you want for it? Deal.
Diet Mountain Dew. Yeah, it tastes that good.
Hey, Hotshot. Meter's running.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey. How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
Around here, we grew up in the kitchen. We learned how to cook when our parents taught us what their parents taught them. At Bojangles, our master biscuit makers use traditional Southern recipes too. From scratch, the old-fashioned way. It's harder, but it's better. Around here, kitchens have always brought folks together, and we're going to make sure they do so for a long time to come. Head to Bojangles and try our hickory-flavored smoked sausage on a made-from-scratch buttermilk biscuit. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, you played three games in 3 days, and now all of a sudden you're playing a fourth. But guess what, folks? Coach even said, guys, I think you have the strength to have a good, hard two-hour practice as well. So when you factor that time in, you're almost saying 5 games in 5 days, Coach. But you knew your young men could do it.
Well, I mean, that's what's really going on this time of year. You see people right. playing tournaments in Puerto Rico or all over
Islands
the country. And that's what teams are doing. They're playing 3 or 4 games in a tournament atmosphere, and you've got to be ready to go, and you've got to get, you know, tougher. We're thinking about scheduling this game on Wednesday, but that being too close to Thanksgiving. Right. So we did move it up to Tuesday. But our guys, we got back into Charlotte Monday and afternoon. And then we did have about an hour and a half practice. And the guys did extremely well. And they knew last Tuesday before that we didn't play the kind of defense that we wanted to play. And couldn't have been proud of our guys at practice and their preparation. And then going into that game of putting defense first.
Well, that says something about the character of your young men that are able to come off of that 3-game trip, still put in a good physical practice getting ready for Toccoa Falls. We're going to go ahead and take a look at those highlights because PC did have their legs. That was something I was looking for.
Again, going against Tekoa. They played zone. Really proud of Jordan Downey. He was very patient. He scored 23 points in 19 minutes. Great contest there. Pushing the basketball. Want to go down there inside. Again, post-feeding. Again, we probably could have got down there inside the wheel. Again, moving the ball against the zone. We had the most assists we've had all year. But you need to have assists against the zone because you got to make some passes. Great pass there by Jaron coming off the bench. Again, we played team defense. Didn't let him get it to the rim. Held him to 40 points, which is what we wanted to do. Again, Jordan going straight up. When he goes straight up and straight down and gets his feet exactly straight going towards the rim and not off balance, he'll make a lot of shots. Again, ball movement. Janiel driving it down there. Great finish there by Janiel under the rim. Again, we stop him. We're on the break. Great pitch ahead. Again, straight up and straight down. And Jordan taking just tremendous shots that were uncontested shots. Great contest there by Marcus. Great rebound by Ruben. Great outlet. Great speed here by Janiel. Trying to get it up there, knowing they're going against the zone. And that's the way we want to look inside down there to Big Will. And great tip in there by Ruben. Again, it starts with getting the defense stop. Good job getting over there on the tape. Again, turnovers. Very unselfish here. Great job. Great pass from Devon there. Driving the ball, kicking. And then Devon driving it, passing it off to Will. Again, having assists, which is the way we want to play. Very unselfish. We couldn't have said that a week ago against Piedmont. And then Devon was in there that morning working on that very shot. And hitting that shot. Again, running a little set play here against the zone. Great screen there by Ed. And great pass by Devon. And getting a good shot there. Again, nice pass. Great. Again, straight up and straight down. Great team defense. Everybody getting in there. Again, pushing the basketball. Running secondary against the zone. Again, screening right here, and Austin makes an extra pass right inside there to Ruben. Very unselfish by Austin. Again, second half, they stayed with the zone. We're running some set plays against there, getting the ball down inside. Great pass there by Ed. And again, that was awesome there. Again, Jordan getting great looks. Great hustle by Will Truss. Hustling back and making that block. He had 6 blocks for the game. Again, Ruben getting the ball in the middle of the floor. He's going to be one of the best players I think that's ever played at Presbyterian. He's just got skills. Again, pushing the ball, Janiel. Very unselfish here. Very unselfish there by Ed, Jordan, and then dropping it off. Good contest. Good block out. Good rebound by Will. Again, getting a defense, great pitch ahead, great down inside there by Austin again, and great finish by Ruben running that floor, which Ruben does an excellent job of running the floor.
Coach, a couple of things that I took away from that game is the legs again, PC showing a lot of endurance there, playing so much basketball. Also, boy, you're right, Arroyo Felix, this young man could play. I didn't know that he could handle the ball and have some different moves and really have a good feel of the game. And so he was exciting to watch. Will Truss defensively, again, blocks, rebounds. He's turning into a complete ball player for you.
Well, that's what we're looking for both out of our seniors, as we knew that early on in the year, that if we're going to have a really good basketball team, we got a young team. Freshmen and sophomores are going to make mistakes. But Jordan and Will Truss really have to be our two best effort guys defensively, and then obviously their principles and getting where they're supposed to be, whether in man or zone, that those two guys have to be relentless defensively. Jordan was tremendous defense against Tocoa Falls, and then he had a great offensive game. Will Truss has been given defense, which has been tremendous in the man and the zone.
And the thing I like about Will Truss, he's left-handed, but now that drop step, using the opposite hand and looking real comfortable with it, as well, and you're right, Coach, about Jordan Downing. Exceptional defense, which improved last year from his sophomore to his junior season. We really saw him step up, and now he stepped up again. Now, this is all happening with the loss of Reggie Dillard, as you know, and also Murray. who had his surgery as we take a look at our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report.
Well, we did. It was a very successful surgery on Monday, and mm-hmm. about the time that we got back from our trip, drove out there, and he was just getting released with this surgery, and it went very well. And right now, hopefully, we're going to try to get him back for the Gardner-Webb game on December 31st, but at least maybe back by January 5th is when we go. We got Winthrop here at home on January 8th, and then Reggie will have his surgery after finals and be able to stay at home there a little bit, and he'll be ready to go for next year.
Okay, awesome. Coach, let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the Bear Transport. Look ahead for the opponents of the Blue Hose, two of them on the slate, Saturday at the Templeton Center against Bob Jones, and then a big one against the Wofford Terriers midweek next week. We'll take a look at those matchups when we return.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken made from scratch, buttermilk biscuits, and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run!
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. The city of Clinton, where the tea is sweet and the tea is silent. And by Hickory Hills Barbecue, for all your barbecue catering needs.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Now let's take a look at the Bear Transport, next week's opponent.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
All righty, Coach. Two of them on the slate at the Templeton Center beginning later on today as you entertain Bob Jones, and then a big one as you go to Spartanburg to take on the Wofford Terriers on a Wednesday night tip.
Well, we do, and our women play at 2 today, and Coach Fisher is doing a tremendous job with his basketball team, had some great wins, and then we play at 4:30, so mm-hmm. hopefully everybody can come out there at 2 and 4:30, and just hopefully, again, we can put two back-to-back defensive games together and then get that out of the way, and then next Wednesday at 7, playing Wofford, which we haven't played them, I believe, since the 1995-96 season, so We're really looking forward to them being back on the schedule, and then they will come, you know, to Presbyterian the following year, and excited about that rivalry again being rekindled. And they've got one of their best teams that they've had that Mike Young thinks he's had to go into the NCAA last year. That's right. And got all those guys back. So love to get the PC faithful up there, going up to Spartanburg next Wednesday at 7.
All righty, and as you mentioned, this is going to be a renewed rivalry. Is this something that we may see continue after this home-and-home?
Well, we want to hope so. And we'll have Furman on the schedule, which we played Furman before. Right. They'll be back on the schedule, and next year we'll go to Furman, and Furman will come to our place and love to play, you know, Wofford and trying to get the Citadel. So really getting those three schools that we enjoy playing right here in South Carolina, and we can get those three teams on the schedule non-conference-wise.
Be also interesting to see how much turkey your young men have eaten and how they perform on Saturday and then on Wednesday. Real quick, Coach, we didn't mention this. I want to now. Devon Bell's actually stepping up to handle the point now more.
Well, he sure is, and that's the lead quarterback, and you're always trying to search for that. And it gets Austin Anderson over there, who's just doing a tremendous job over there so he can shoot and get him running off screens, and it's best for Austin. And where Austin's been awesome too is him helping those point guards out with his experience. And obviously he'd like to be starting, but he's coming off the bench, but just doing a tremendous job with those guys and got Janiel and Devon in there, two great quarterbacks. And how exciting that is. I think those guys are going to do nothing but get better and better.
All righty, Gregg Nibert, thank you very much for joining us. Hope you had a wonderful and safe Thanksgiving. And we hope that this has been a pleasant start for your holiday season as well. For the Coach Gregg Nibert, I'm Eric Thacker. Hope to see you again next week. Till then, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax. You're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton. We'd like to thank the following Blue Hose sponsors: Swaim Brown Accounting Services and Wealth Management with David Ramage, Bishop Tire, Pepsi Cola, Number One Sign Designs, Nichols Automotive, Foothills Motorsports, Arthur State Bank, Babcock Sports, Domino's Pizza, Streamers, Pizza Hut, Sodexo Food Services, The Camp Team, Hampton Inn. Thank you again for being Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors.